Hey, how's it going? This is Q. I'm a metal fabricator here at my shop in California. So today I'm going to be working, or actually finishing up, a sink that I've been working on. It's kind of got a spiderweb theme to it. I've been working on it for a little bit, about a day or so, 2 days into it. Most of it's made out of square tubing, rectangle tubing, and then also some solid round bar and 5/16 round bar. So this is what it is right now. This is what I have. So as you can see, I got spider webs going on all three sides. The back, I don't need it because it's going up against the wall. This is square tubing. This here is rectangle, same with this. I got this inset a little bit, that way I can put the sink or the sink bowl fit in there without moving around when I, you know, attach it. This right here is 3/8 solid round tubing. This is 5/16, and today I'm going to be finishing up the door, which is here. I'll put hinges on this side. I kind of spaced it out and stuck it tight to this side so I have enough clearance for the hinges and also for when it opens and closes. So just to give you an idea, this is what I start out with. I roll this is 5/16, and then I'll cut like sections of it, you know, depending on the size that I need for the spiderweb. So like, for instance, these are almost, you know, 2.5 inches, and it goes up from there, you know, 3.5, 4.5, 5.5, depending on how it fits. I try to space these evenly so that it looks, you know, so I guess is that you want to try and space them evenly. If you space them kind of off, it might look a little awkward. Even this, I probably should have stuck another one in here. But anyway, well, you know, it's for my shop, so I kind of just, I missed that one, but anyway, it'll work. Okay, so we moved on. We got the door opening and closing here. We put on the hinges. I left them kind of long. It doesn't matter. I'll probably cut them later before I paint it. I'm going to do just an easy grind, get rid of the burn marks, clean it up. And then, so now I'm getting ready to put a cover between here on the back side so you can still see the spider web. And I'm also going to do it down here. So this is my sheet metal. I'm gonna get ready to plasma cut this. And so I'll show you what I'm doing right now. I'm just gonna make my cuts so that I can fit it inside here, and then I'll trace those out and put them in. So let's go to it.
All right, right now I want to put a
brace in so it doesn't fall through. Okay, and then we'll cut the rest of this. So I'm not going to go all the way up because I like leaving some of these. They almost look like little rivets or something. For me, I think it's kind of decorative. So I'm going to leave those. Let's see here. Alright, so on this we're just gonna freehand it and then we'll clean it up with the grinder. Trying to grind with the way that the, let's see here, with the way that the web would be. Actually screwed up right there. Right now what we're going to do is we're going to give this piece kind of like a texture. So I usually just give it a light grind with some 80 grit, kind of with the grinder like this, same grinder. And we're just going to give it a light kind of texture over the top of just the tubing, not the spider webs. And only, well, you could do the spider webs if you want, but then it gives it kind of a different contrast. And since we have it the same on the metal panels that are going to go on the inside, I feel I'm going to just leave those alone and just do the rectangle bar. So we're just going to give that a quick grind. I'll show you how I do it, and then we'll just keep going. All right. Okay, so this, rather than spraying it solid, because I want some of this to pop through, I'm gonna just give it a light coat. So that means... So just like that. All right, so now I'm just gonna, since I already did that light one, what I'm gonna do is do something like this, where I just give it a quick light grind over the top. You're not grinding too heavy. And obviously you want to go towards the way the spider web is running. There, just like that. So now we'll move on to this. Let's see. Okay, that's good enough. You don't have to overdo it. Once it's stalled, it's not going to be moving unless there's an earthquake here in California, so you won't hear it. And then also there's some gaps on the back, and I mean, if those happen, you can actually just run a bead of like black silicone in the back there, and then you won't see it. You know, for me, again, it's not gonna make a huge difference because of what I'm using it for. It's more of a decorative piece. Dead. Right. So the door, hopefully this one isn't as tricky. Okay, here it hangs over a little bit, which won't be a problem. However, it does hit that grind just right there. So I'm gonna give it a quick little, or weld. So I'm gonna give it a quick little grind. Ah, shit. What it's gonna look like. So see, now you can see how it shines a little bit more. That way when you clear coat it, this isn't solid black like that. It loses depth. You know what I mean? This gives it a lot more depth. And since this is not grinded, this is grinded, you know, it gives another texture for it. That's pretty much it for right now. I'm just gonna clean it up again. Like I said, I'm just gonna use the palm of my hand and a blower. The best way, you just want to remove some of that excess. I usually clean it twice. I clean it once like this, set it on the ground, clean it. So here's the piece. So it's pretty much ready to clear coat. I cleaned it a couple times again, like I was saying, with my just kind of like with my hands and then with an air nozzle. So this is how it's gonna look. I'm gonna clear it. It'll deepen up the black a little bit, you know, bring out the steel a little bit more, especially where it's like shining. So, in the next step, what I'm gonna do is I'll probably set up my other camera. That way we can clear it. I'm gonna use automotive clear and it, since everything's grinded, it'll adhere to it pretty good.
Nuclear error, but I have no fear, 'cause London.